Welcome to chemistry class. Myself Mahesh R. I am taking engineering chemistry class for you. Today we will discuss first unit, natural resources and their management. It consists of three subtopics: water technology, chemical fuels and solar energy. Water is one of the wonderful, precious gift of nature to all living organisms. Water is required for domestic and industry purpose as well as agriculture purposes. Health and wealth of the nation mainly depends upon availability and utilization of quality of water available. Our first subunit, it related to water technology. It covers the specification of potable water with respect to World Health Organization and the parameters which influences the quality of water, like hardness, biological oxygen demand, chemical oxygen demand and related problems. This subtopic also covers the purification of water by reverse osmosis. Second subunit deals with energy sources with respect to fuels. In this subtopic, we will understand the knocking tendency in internal combustion engine with respect to both petrol and diesel engines. We will also discuss how to assess the quality of petrol and diesel samples using octane number and CT number respectively. Heating efficiency of the chemical fuels usually expressed in terms of calorific value. It may be gross calorific value or net calorific value. We will cover the relationship between gross calorific value and net calorific value in the second subunit. The last subunit, we will discuss about energy harvesting, which includes construction and working of dye-sensitized solar cell and its advantages over silicon based solar cell. In today's class, I am going to cover what do you mean by analysis of water, hardness of water, what are the effects of hardness, what is the reason behind hardness, types of hardness like temporary and permanent hardness, and unit to express hardness. Analysis of water. It involves determination of various parameters present in the water in order to assess the quality of water and its utility. The different constraints generally determined are hardness, alkalinity, dissolved oxygen, fluoride, nitrate, sulfate, etc. As I mentioned earlier, water is required for everyone. While selecting suitable sites for industry, an engineer would consider the following aspects: quality of water available, quantity of water needed, impurities present in it and their effects. It is necessary to detect and estimate the amount of these substances in the water sample. Such an analysis will help us in deciding methods to decrease the amount of these impurities to an optimum level so that water is fit for the usage. Hardness of water. It is a characteristic property of water which does not give lather when it is treated with the soap solution. When rainwater comes in contact with the minerals present in the earth crust, which imparts hardness. These minerals generally containing calcium and magnesium salts and other heavy metal ions. They are responsible for hardness. Types of water. Water does not give lather when it is treated with a soap solution is known as hard water. Water which gives lather when treated with soap solution is known as soft water. What is the reason behind hardness? Soap is usually sodium or potassium salt of higher fatty acids like stearic acid. When soap is treated with hard water, calcium or magnesium salts react with some amount of soap, forming insoluble calcium or magnesium stearates which float at the top in the form of scum, which is insoluble. As long as this compound will be there, it does not give lather when treated with the soap solution. Temporary hardness and permanent hardness depend upon the type of substance presented. We classify them as temporary hardness substances and permanent hardness substance. Calcium, bicarbonates of calcium and magnesium salts are responsible for temporary hardness. If water containing these salts on boiling, their hardness can be removed. Whereas chlorides and sulfates of calcium and magnesium salts present in the water, even after boiling, their hardness cannot be removed. Hence, they are called as permanent hardness causing substances. Effects of hardness. If you look at the domestic wise, presence of hardness causing substance leads to wastage of soap. With respect to industry, in boilers, there is a formation of scales which corrodes in boilers. Wastage of fuels also takes place. Even in some pipes, there is a blockage due to deposition of salts. Finally, it leads to corrosion. In case of textile industry, during dyeing of process, calcium and magnesium salts present in the water contaminate the quality of shading. Units. Hardness of water usually expressed by following units. PPM. It is defined as number of parts by mass of hardness causing substance present in 1 million parts by mass of water. Generally, it is milligram per dmq. Degree Clerk. Number of grains of hardness causing substance present in 1 gallon of water. 1 gallon equals to 3.78 liters. Degree French. As the name indicates, it is a French system. Number of parts by mass of hardness causing substance present in 10 to the power of 5 parts by mass of water. Any sample of hard water contains variety of impurities with different amounts. The degree of hardness due to all these substances are expressed in the form of calcium carbonate. Reasons for representing in calcium carbonate equivalents are: calcium carbonate, which is insoluble in water, it does not impart hardness. Its molecular mass is 100, easy for the calculation. It can be calculated by using this formula: mass of hardness causing substance divided by molecular mass of hardness causing substance multiplied by molecular mass of calcium carbonate. Or you can calculate with respect to chemical equivalent of hardness causing substance and the chemical equivalent of calcium carbonate also. Numerical problem. In the current problem, different amounts of hardness causing substance are given. They impart hardness. We have to calculate temporary and permanent hardness. First task is we have to find out which are the salts responsible for temporary hardness causing substance and permanent hardness causing substance. In the current problem, calcium bicarbonate and magnesium bicarbonate are responsible for temporary hardness causing substance and their amount is given. Its hardness can be calculated by using previous formula. First, we have to calculate the molecular mass of these substances. Temporary hardness of calcium bicarbonate, it comes out to be 9.56 milligram per dm3, whereas magnesium bicarbonate found to be 20 milligram per dm3. Similarly, we have to calculate the hardness with respect to magnesium chloride and calcium carbonate, calcium sulfate, found to be 0.5 and 10.0 milligram per dm3. The second problem, homework for you. So it containing 16.2 milligram per dm3 of calcium sulfate and 1.4 milligram per dm3 of magnesium bicarbonate and 9.5 milligram per dm3 of magnesium chloride. We have to calculate temporary and permanent hardness by same methods. Examination corner. The first question related to 2 or 3 marks. Define hardness of water and what are the reasons for it. Whereas second one, descriptive question. We have to explain properly which are the salts responsible for temporary hardness causing substance and permanent hardness causing substance with reason. Summary. Today we learnt what do you mean by analysis of water, hardness of water, different types of hardness, what is the reason behind it, different units to express hardness, and numerical problems in it.